Okay, we're going to be climbing a hill, an upgrade for a good mile or two, heading north. So, I mentioned once or twice before, this guy from New York in the Bronx will ride the same bike I do. He's got a vlog called Riding with Jav, and posted a video recently saying that he's taking a break for a while. Sounded kind of tired. Not tired of writing, I think he's tired of editing and uploading videos. I wished him the best, and I know that it'd be great if he'd start up again, because his content is pretty cool. I like that he rides in the city. He's got a lot of energy in his videos. I think the thing that might also be going on, I think he's a recent college grad, and I think he just started working, and that might be where a lot of his energy is going. It's a little different when you're not working. You'll be able to get on a bike and ride when you want, and play around making videos, editing them, and spending the time that you need to upload them to YouTube. But when you're working, welcome to being a grown-up. Of course, I'm on the other side of that coin now. Semi-retired. To ride when I want, how often I want, as long as the weather cooperates. And even if it doesn't cooperate, I think I might have mentioned at one time, the only thing that really stops me from riding is snow or rain. But even the snow, if the roads are clear, there's no reason why I can't ride. I generally do. But I can't see riding in the rain. Well, first of all, you need fenders on your bike. You can't possibly go riding on wet roads with a rooster tail from your wheels hitting you both in the face and on the ass. Can't do that for very long without coming to your senses and saying, "Are you kidding me? Why would I do this?" So, yeah, I didn't go through the trouble of throwing fenders on my bike so that I could ride when it's roads are wet. Although I suppose if you're a commuter, and that's what you use to commute, your bike, that is, absolutely, put on a set of fenders, go to town. And the flag is blowing there a little bit. Yeah, so Job is taking a hiatus, I suppose. I think he mentioned that he's a marshal for what's it, Staten Island tour, or I guess some sort of road event that happens on Staten Island. I don't know if I got that right. So he's still an active rider. He's just cutting back on recording his rides on video just yet. He also mentioned he wants to upgrade his camera, go to a GoPro Hero 4 Black. I personally run a GoPro Hero 3 White, which I think is more than enough camera for this kind of recording. But I think what happened with Job is he bought a refurbished camera from Amazon or something, which is a Hero 3, I think. But you can tell there's like a dead spot right in the middle of the lens. And it looks like something's stuck on the lens, like a blurred image or something. So I think he finally got to the point where he figured he can't deal with that goofy lens anymore, or that defect in the lens. But I wonder if you can replace the lens. You know, I don't know if you have to buy a whole new camera. Because the Hero 4 Black, I think, must be the top end, I would guess. It's got to be a $400 or $500 camera. But whatever he decides to do, I hope he does it soon and gets back on the old video vlog routine that he was on. For the longest time, I was using my iPhone to record my videos. I found a clamp and a chest harness designed to hold an iPhone, and it kind of worked okay. But the one real nice thing about the iPhone videos that I had recorded at one time, it has the iPhone has image stabilization on it, and it really made a difference in terms of the video quality. But the video also didn't have the same wide angle perspective that you get from GoPros, plus the fact that you were limited to how long of a video you could record with the iPhone. What I mean by that is that the iPhone itself, its storage capacity kind of dictated just how long a video you could record, because obviously the bigger, longer the video, the more space it took up on your storage, and therefore you just may run out of storage and have your video chopped off when you're trying to do something. It was more than 30, 40 minutes. I think maybe I got an hour. I think I did a calculation at one time. If I kept everything cleared off the phone, I can do about 45, 50 minute video. Anyway, I don't do that anymore. I use a GoPro like everybody else. sniffing. Oh boy. You know, it's so subconscious that I do that. But I know once I start playing back the videos and start to edit them, I'll hear all that sniffling going on. I'll go, oh crap. It really takes away from the what I try to do when I record. Okay, I have a major hill to climb here, so I just have to take my time and get up it. A little more like springtime right now. A little bit warmer than when we were by the water. Which is to be expected. So not a bad ride this morning. Talked about one of the side benefits of upgrading my wheel set was the brakes stay much quieter for much longer periods of time. I haven't had any issue with brake pads getting dirty or gritty because of the rims being a problem. They're quiet and smooth, they work great. I talked a little bit about some of the things that I like about Strava, and one of the interesting things that I made an observation about where Strava and my bike computer don't complete 100% on trip distances that I make. Strava is 99% correct. And that's a result of how Strava and GPS systems in general calculate distances, as opposed to a bike computer, which records actual distances that you are traveling, rolling your wheel across the ground. I think I had one or two more topics that I wanted to talk about on my ride this morning, but that's not necessary. I mean, sometimes it's just great to watch the road go by if you're a cyclist, see what other guys are doing. I will once again mention how extremely happy I am that I spent a few extra bucks and put some upgrades into my entry-level road bike. This bike runs great. It's quiet, it's smooth, shifts perfectly. Worth every penny I put into it and every penny I spent on it. Yeah. I actually had a dream about riding my bike the other day, now that I'm remembering it. I think I was on the road, obviously, something on a hill, at the top of a hill somewhere, and I was overlooking what looked like, I believe, the ocean or a body of water. And I was in the process of beginning my video by saying hello to everyone. Hey, this is the road biker, and giving a date as I generally do. And as I did that, some guy kind of interrupted me off from the side, came over to me and started talking to me about something. And the next thing I know, this guy was kind of challenging everything that I was talking about. And then somehow we got into a discussion about board games of all things, because I've always hated board games. Maybe that's why it was part of my dream, I don't know. Very odd. See that Subaru? The Subarus always are friendly people, went right around me. So anyway. Yeah, so this just is about right on the cusp of turning 30 miles on this ride this morning. It was nice to get out. I actually thought that I was going to do more in the way of commentary on this video this morning, and maybe ultimately break it up into smaller segments based on topics. But maybe I'll just string the whole thing together. Put up a big fat video. Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, friends and neighbors, always, as always, great to be on the bike.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you will subscribe to this channel. Subscribe by clicking that subscribe box you see just right there. And as always, your comments are welcome, so please feel free to post them. This is the Road Biker. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.